Those lip-smacking treats neither come out of thin air nor for free. Think of it this way. All food is the result of someone's hard work. He is the farmer, the man closest to the soil. He needs land to grow crops, water for irrigation, also oil and electricity to run his tools and machines. If food is wasted, all the hard work and resources are also wasted. Someone could have used that wasted water in Rajasthan. Some poor man's home could have used that wasted electricity. All this land wasted for food that someone threw away. And most importantly, that wasted food could have been a day's meal for someone who goes to sleep empty stomach every night.
I mean, if all the wastes are gathered, a dish can be made. Something like this is the condition.
Those children who are bringing the junk food, others are very much eager to have those food because they are feeling much tempted towards those junk foods, chips and chocolates and pizzas and all. And the homemade food, they are least interested. So what is happening at the end, they are scared that when they will return home with their full tiffin box, they will get the scoldings from their parents. So they are just throwing the food. So the result is the wastage.
It is obvious that children prefer tasty, oily, fried and fun food.
Burgers, pizzas, rolls,
chips, kurkure,
little bit spicy food,
cake, chow mein,
chips, spices, kaju,
cake, samosas, nimki.
One child of my class, she told that my mother has prepared roll for me, and next to the child, he has bring a tutti frutti cake. Obviously, that child is not interested.
My father is a driver.
Also, it seems that children's preference for junk food transcends socio-economic
boundaries. I like Stephen. I like to eat the food. I like to eat spicy food. I like to eat noodles. I like to eat maximum roti.
Parents will like to give them the healthy food.
And some children, those who are very interested with the food, most of the foods are outside junk food. That's the thing. Maximum time home cooked food usually go to our dustbin. Mothers are providing nutritious fruits. Fruits is going to the dustbin. And they are very much interested to share the chips packets or kurkure or Cadbury's.
They are always thinking the other's tiffin is better than his own tiffin. Whatever mother has sent, that's not so much good. Better whatever others has brought, that is better. This is the thing, what is?
Parents cannot always give children what they want for health and other issues.
First preference Maggie.
Maggie ta beshi prefer kore.
Junk food bhushan bhabe chai. But ami di na tiffin ta.
Maggie or noodles or pasta in tiffin, and I just don't like to give them.
So ami khub dry ebong simple tiffin dewa pochondo kori.
Problems with his digestive system, so I just send her with biscuit or cakes.
Fruits di majhe majhe apple, cucumber, egulo ami dite.
Amar bachche emni khawa niye bhishon jhamela kore, oke ami biscuit ba ektu cake ba ektu fruits ei di.
Seems the tasty junk food is inversely proportional to the quantity of food wasted, which means if more tasty food is given, children will waste less and vice versa.
I teach them that don't waste the food because the foods are very valuable. Parents are working so hard, but they are little kids. They don't have that much capacity to understand all the economic problem and all those things. They want the variety. I spoke to them.
But taste can be altered in many ways. We can give the healthy food, but at the same time, we can change the taste so that the child can have some interest in their food.
If the food is become interesting, they will have the food and go for play.
This issue of food wastage is not all about lack of interesting and fun food.
Most of them interested more in the games or sports. Somehow they are taking the tiffin and they are rushing out.
I frequently see that my friends are throwing food particles to each other.
They are not at all interested in their food. All the time they are playing, running, rushing, pushing, all these things.
Generally our class is always dirty, littered with paper balls. She always gives us zero for cleanliness, that's her reaction, and she always gets angry.
First though, they are very fond of playing. No use of having those food just to go and play.
I think they need another short break. Suppose for the tiffin break, they can take that tiffin there, and last that the bigger that for half an hour break, they can go to play. If any short break they can, the school can provide.
There should be some supervision. Maybe the school captain can take the decision, the school captain can arrange this one, fix some people, those who look after this matter when in time of tiffin, the tiffin line, etc. For the junior section also, they can counsel the students as fast as they should have the tiffin after that. Moreover, they can get this type of instruction from the class teacher also. Some teacher may be in duty also in time of tiffin.
We are all aware that food is being wasted. But how many of us go and pick up a wrapper and see that there are some biscuits or not, and let us give it to a... Even if we give it to a dog, it will eat. It will have something with it. But we don't give that. It's just, let's drop it and go away. So, if we are just aware, it's not the solution. We have to think that... I mean, only if we have love for the world, if we think for the world, we can make it a better place.
We all are responsible. We all are sometimes greedy, inconsiderate, and disrespectful towards food. The only way out is a collaboration between students, teachers, and parents to work together and find means to curb food wastage and play our part as a small cog in a big machine.